According to the UNEB spokesperson, Jennifer Kalule, it was discovered that the school administrator provided fake results to candidates on testimonial forms. UNEB learned that all the 114 affected candidates used these testimonials with inaccurate results to enroll in Senior 1.
Paying fees for a child, only to reach the tail end, they cannot sit exams because there is a problem at the foundation of P7. So by the time they wake up, it will be late. That's why we say the public needs to be in the know. We have requested the committee to call upon parents to bring their results for verification. This particular school, we are going to issue a circular, and then parents will be called upon to bring their results for verification and confirm whether this child's results were released or cancelled. If they were cancelled, the child is taken out of secondary, repeats P7. If they were released, they give them the actual results and withdraw the fake results. It's all in the interest of the public and protection of the child.
Kalule further urged all secondary schools enrolling learners in Senior 1 and 5 to authenticate UNEB results by cross-referencing them with the provided code 6600.
Those schools, we give them 15 days to come to us, and so the school, when we release results, schools have the entire printout, they have access to the printout from their portals. We also ask the guests to come and pick the printouts. So we do expect the schools to either hang them on the school notebooks or even the parents to go to schools and establish the presence of data. Look at the spelling of the name, look at the order of the name, look at the date of birth, year and month of birth, ensure that everything is correct. So once that is confirmed, and then if you don't get any requests or inquiries, then we can be able to print the result slip. So usually we do print after like a month, because we give them about 15 days to give us the queries, after the release, to give us the queries, and then we do correct our own data, and then we can be able to print the results.
Meanwhile, the Minister of Education and Sports delivered a stern warning to her teachers regarding the forceful removal of teachers from school payroll in the absence of permanent appointment letters. The Director of Basic Education, Ismael Mulindwa, speaking on behalf of the Ministry's Permanent Secretary, Katie Lamaro, emphasized the necessity to halt such actions immediately. He made the remarks during the Senior 5 selection exercise at Umma Multipurpose Hall.
Similarly, I urge you to regularly sensitize your staff on government policies, laws and regulations, including the Teachers Professional Code of Conduct, the Public Service Standing Orders, the National Teacher Policy, the National Physical Education and Sports Policy, the TVET Policy, and others. TA teachers, you are requested to be able to implement these policies and get to know what they require of you.
The event, attended by numerous ministry officials, teachers and head teachers, convened to select approximately 236,280 learners from a pool of 2,042 teachers. The chairperson of the selection exercise, Jane Egao, underscored the importance of fairness and integrity in the selection process, urging teachers to refrain from engaging in corrupt practices.
I'd like to emphasize that the rationale for this centralized placement exercise is really to ensure equity, fairness, and transparency in admissions, especially admissions to government schools.
Report compiled by Sharon Navasidie for the news.